Hello and welcome back, everybody. Whoops, that was my keyboard. To Clannad. So, last episode, we got a bad ending. And now I have to figure out what I did wrong. My first initial thought was I probably should have done maybe something perverted. I'm not 100% sure. But my second thought, and that seemed more appropriate, was that I have to say, I think things can't go on like this. Like, I don't know what it is about, maybe that they're supposed to be more like lovers or something like that. Or at least something in that direction. But it seems like this is a very essential decision. While the decisions during their stay at Tomoyo's house were all like seemed more random to me. So let's say I think things can't go on like this. Okay, that doesn't even change anything. Yeah. Okay, let's first try silently let Tomoyo handle this, and then we do the interfere thing. Okay, already different, okay. And so, the three of us finally spent our lunch break together again. It was fun. And at the end, I said to the both of them, are you two free after school? Yeah. So how about you come along with me later then? Sports. I just figured it would be nice to break a healthy sweat once in a while. Oh god, now that I think about it, I probably should have done the handshake scene with Kyo. Like, that seems super likely, doesn't it? Like, they were on such good terms after that. Or at least more than when he did not interfere. So, I'm sorry. You know, I usually don't do this, but this is already the second time in this route, so, you know. Okie dokie. Okay, so now we're on good terms with Kyo. And it seems to be different already, so let's see. Oh yeah, you actually do have really good reflexes, don't you?
Money.
But I guess it's true that if we put you in, you'd just be so good that you'd throw off the balance of the game. Come on, Sunohara, even you should see through this tactic. Suddenly, he's become totally motivated. How about you, Tomoyo? Oh, that's unfortunate. Nah, it'll be fine. You can just stay in your school clothes. I won't let you jump up and down or anything, so don't worry. So it's decided then. After school, we come down onto the sports field. Okay, I'm still confused though what the things can't go on like this. Like, what did that change? What was the change, you know? Maybe I'll realize later, but as of now, it's... I don't really get it. Like, is it more of a... I know we have to be a couple even when she gets elected more of a... Things can't go on like this. Or more of a... We have to break up sooner for Tomoyo's sake, or I don't know. I'm confused. Right in front of us, the baseball club is in the middle of the practice. Yeah. It's fine. Since these are the guys we're going up against. I ignore Tomoyo's words and approach one of the members standing in the coach's box. Say, how about a match? Huh? a baseball match with her. That's right, with you. Just go along with it for now. He looks at me like I'm making fun of him for proposing he fight a girl. It's not a joke at all. If she loses, we'll go pick up the balls or do any other random chores you have for us. In exchange, if she wins, you have to listen to what she has to say. Oh, we're campaigning! Is that what we're doing? Oh! Okay. Wait, okay, give me a short break. Nope, it was just me. Whoops. He must have ended up being more amused than angry. To be honest, I struck a similar attitude when I still wasn't at all familiar with Tomoyo. I'll let you guys do the defense here, okay? I make sure they can handle grounders or a pop fly. To be fair, even when you are very strong, throwing has to do a lot with technique, and I mean a lot. Like, I can throw to save my life, and now I'm not a bodybuilder or something, but I'm like, strength-wise, I'm average. But throwing, I have like the weakest throw of all time. So man, I don't know if that is actually... I doubt this would work in real life. Let's put it like this. He says that as if trying to appease a child. And when I turn back to look at the club members... And so he orders them. Yeah, that's fair. Well then, Sunohara... Yeah, sure, you are the one who gets the ball thrown in his face all the time. Yeah, you've got such incredible reflexes after all. I'll be counting on you then. This guy is so easy to manipulate. He goes off, borrows the catcher's mitt and nothing else, and stands himself at a home base. Yeah, he's definitely going to get one in the face. Don't you need a mask? Tomoyo, let's start practicing your pitching. I shout out to Tomoyo, who's standing at the mound. She makes a few practice throws. Sunohara stands up and shows her the proper form. Yeah, well, that's even logical to me. Like, if you use the whole body, the power of your lower half of the body, you can put all your weight behind the throw in your arm, you know? That is basic physics. Sunohara sits himself down again and punches his catcher's mitt in anticipation. Tomoyo winds up the ball and behind her back. Everyone looks up high into the sky. The ball was stuck high into the back fence. It's so buried into the wireframe that it won't fall back down. The club members that are on defense start booing loudly. It was a high ball, but even so, it somehow found its place in Sunohara's catcher's mitt. The club members witnessing this pitch all simultaneously fall silent. Well, just judging from the path of the ball, anyone could see that the pitch wasn't something for amateurs. Yeah. Whatever that means, sir. Don't be too strict. You're playing an amateur, after all. The captain stands himself behind Sunohara. The club member whose name was just called enters the batter box. She goes through the pitching motion. A foul. It hits the fence behind us. The second ball. It was a low ball.
Strike, da yo na. Shiroto nan da shi.
Strike!
Sunohara, despite being a simpleton, you're pretty good at manipulating people like this. Yeah, I guess the rules don't apply to, the rules don't apply to himself, you know, about manipulating. What? I don't even know what I'm talking about. Third ball. The pitch goes wild. Again, it strikes the fence behind us. Someone throws her a new ball. The fourth ball. The ball went high. However, the batter couldn't help but swing anyway.
Swing out!
Yes! Tomoyo, you did it!
Yeah, fair enough. In this case, I'm really on his side. Well, now you're just shitting on him for shitting on him. The next batter stands himself on the box. His body is incredibly large, and judging from his physique, it looks like he's the flagship player of the team.
Tomoyo, zutai dake da. Kini sunna.
Dakara omae ni iwaretaku nai.
Yoshi koi.
The first ball. The last ball is probably going to be in his face or something. It was low.
Nanda Tomoyo? Sore demo moto koushien pitcher ka?
That is probably a reference. It's either a Japanese team or it's an anime reference or something like that.
Sonna kakko nante nai. Ima hajimete nageteru nda zo.
The second ball. Another ball that's too high and crashes into the fence.
Omoidase Tomoyo.
Like, now it comes actually into play that I have no idea about baseball rules. So basically, I don't know how many balls she has. You know how many balls she has? Okay. But yeah, I don't know how many she can throw, like, off the trail. So, maybe it's important right now to actually throw it, like, in the direction of the batter. The third ball. The ball hits the ground with incredible force. On the bounce, it flies far over Sunohara. The fourth ball. It's fine. He can have a walk. And if he ever hits home base, it will still be your win. It looks like Sunohara has caused Tomoyo to lose her composure. Yeah, he can agitate both his enemies and his friends. After that, Tomoyo wasn't even able to pitch a single strike. In the end, all the bases had runners on them. So okay, as mentioned, I have only limited understanding of baseball. So on all the bases, there are people now. And if one goes, like the one on the last base goes home, they get a point and Tomoyo loses. Okay. I think I understand that. That is definitely a reference I don't get. Tomoyo calls me. Time out! I come running up to Tomoyo. What is it? What's wrong? I know. Just calm down. Tomoyo. I struggle to find an answer for her. I cannot raise the shoulder of my dominant arm at all, because of the fight I had with my old man. Okay, so this was explained in the general route, okay. Which means I also can throw any balls back to her. I might be able to do it, if catching is all that's involved. But if I really did this for her, I wonder if she would hold back for me and end up throwing only balls that are easy to catch. If she did that, the batter would definitely be able to get in a hit. Would that really be alright? Okay, wait a minute, let me read that through again. This for her. I wonder if she would hold back for me and end up throwing only balls that are easy to catch. If she did that, the batter would definitely... It's back to her. Okay, now I have a problem. A big, big problem. We know what happened in the Nagisa route. When I didn't do shit myself. Because apparently the game hates it when I don't play the anime superhero. On the other hand, the simulation situation is not really that similar. I mean, she might go easy on the other guys if Tomoya is the catcher. Also, there is a ball coming to Sunohara's face that didn't happen. So, he keeps catching, I guess. If catching is all that's involved. But if I really did this for her, I wonder if she would hold back and end up throwing only balls that are easy to catch. If she did that, the batter would definitely be able to hit. Would that be alright? It's not alright. Nope. We have to work hard. I guess that is also the message of the route. Sorry, Tomoyo. I can't use my shoulder. Yeah, long ago at least. This is about as high as I can raise it. Nah. Then, how about we do this? Throw, aiming for Sunohara's face. Ah ha 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 ha. I'm a genius. And try to blow him right off the field. I'm not saying you should really blow him off the field. I'm just saying you should throw with that feeling in mind. Don't even look at his mitt. Look just at Sunohara's odious face. Just try it. I give Tomoyo a clap on the shoulder and step away. Tomoyo then returns to the mount. I feel like those words just now have caused Tomoyo to snap. Tomoyo goes through the pitching motion. She winds up the ball behind her back and throws. Sunohara was blown back. A cloud of dust rises up when he hits the ground. The field falls silent. Everyone is in silent amazement. Hey, umpire, that was a strike just now, right?
Strike!
At the same time, as he calls out, the club members on the field all simultaneously cry out. Even I'm in the mood to shout out to her. Just what was that? Just how fast can you throw this ball? She really has some terrifying prospects for the future. No, actually, she's already really terrifying as it is. You can just hold him up. He'll at least make a nice shield for you. She winds up the second ball behind her back and throws. A strike. The third ball. A strike. Let's hurry up! Name your next batter! The captain was dazed in stupefaction and couldn't manage to say anything. Instead, Tomoyo orders someone to stand batter. Another strike! That makes three. And with that, things were now over. It's the end of the match. Tomoyo wins.
なんだかとてもバカらしいことに真剣になってしまった気がするぞ。だが、かなりうさが晴らせた。よしとするか。
I wonder if that was the right decision. Like, I kind of feel like it was really different, like in the Nagisa route. In the Nagisa route, it was more about Tomoya overcoming himself. Here it's more like Tomoyo overcoming herself, you know? Like the center of this decision was kind of shifted from our protagonist to his love interest, you know? So I feel like if it's the same logic, like the anime hero must do everything himself, it's kind of unfair. But we'll see, I guess. So Nohara is lying on the ground, his face covered in swellings and bruises. He's just sleep talking, don't mind him. The captain suddenly forces his way in between Tomoyo and me. So it's like that, the cup of Japanese baseball. She's a woman, you know. She won't like that, I can tell you as much. But we've already achieved our objective
here.
These guys will definitely vote for you now. The captain is like that, after all. Don't worry about it. I mean, you're the one who actually did it. All I did was watch. Hey, you guys! Just so you know, Tomoyo is a candidate for the student council president. You'd better remember. Also, maybe we promise you some bullshit that will never happen. That's what you do in school. Because that's what you do when you run for positions in school, because you have no power anyway. As we're walking around, we can already hear lots of people gossiping about us. Of course we are. Soccer is probably too difficult for someone without experience, so we'll leave that for later. I mean, penalty shooting should be fine. If she can throw pitches, she can shoot penalties. Let's go up against the softball club next. There will only be underarm throws, so don't worry. Shut up, loser. I personally, to be honest, I also can see this kind of backfire. I mean, there are still the stories about her around, etc. And if they now crush every sports team, like, that probably won't help these rumors, you know? It will only make them, like, probably worse. So I can see that this might not be the most intelligent idea. Why? Well, of course, they will be talking about you. That's part of being endorsed by everyone. Right now, all we just need to do is work hard and wipe out all the bad rumors. Not at all. I've never once tried to force someone to vote for you. People are just charmed by you when faced with your talent. And if you were a man, they might have felt jealous. There is not even that, since you're a woman. Yeah, okay, yeah, if she crushes, as a girl, crushes all the boys' clubs. Yeah, I can see that. He probably has a point. Don't misunderstand, alright? Winning them over with sports, not with violence. This is probably the healthiest thing we could be doing. You're just being too self-conscious about your past. Yeah, I see her point. Oh well, we'll see. Let's just keep working hard like this. Is it me saying so? Weren't you the one putting all your energy into aiming for the student council? Nah. Let's see. Don't you think you'd be good at kendo? She was ridiculously good. The shinai of the regular members didn't even come near her. All she would do was tap lightly on the masks of her opponents, who were actually getting all serious about this.
Tsunohara, today you haven't sweated, right? I'll test
you. Tena, I thought you were going to be the same as this student council member.
However, we didn't have much time. It would have been nice if we were able to have a showdown with all of the clubs. But we didn't even finish with half of them before election day came. I wonder how much we managed to fascinate people with Tomoyo in the last few days. Each class voted during homeroom in their own classroom. All you had to do was circle one of the names on the ballot and hand it back in. I circled Tomoyo's name on my paper. So... Uh-oh. We can skip. Okay, we could only skip the first few sentences. So let's hope the results are different. I kind of have a feeling though this was again so short. The election itself was so short. I have a feeling we still fucked up. Well, if I weren't here, you would have made it into the council easily anyway.
そんなこと言わないでくれ。私は本当に楽しかったんだから。
I enjoyed it too.
ともよ、私はこの時間が終わった後も、今日も明日も、ずっとお前と一緒にいたい。でも、約束だからな。
To be honest, if we did, I didn't really get it.
私がこうして引かないように、お前も引かないだろう。
Oh, I know. Now that I think about it, we actually did make this promise right in the beginning. And then it went kinda like wishy-washy, like... It seemed like it wasn't really in effect anymore, you know? Tomoyo comes close with her mouth. And our mouths meet each other. Continually, until the final moments have arrived. The school broadcast can be heard echoing throughout the classroom. They are letting people know the results of the elections for the student council. The name of the student council president is... Tomoyo. Good! I fucked up the important moment. Tomoyo Sakagami. Or Sakagami, I'm not sure anymore. My chest hurts. It's probably why we stayed like that the entire time. Because this was my answer to her. Yes, this is my answer. She makes our mouths part for a moment and speaks. I guess you're right. I push my lips onto hers once more. Once again, she presses down on my chest and takes her mouth off mine.
Tomoya. 私は今はもう生徒会長なんだ。もうお前の彼女じゃないんだ。だから、もうこんなことはよしてほしい。
No.
わがままなやつだな。
I want to be with you too. Today. And tomorrow. I want to stay like this forever. That is my answer to you.
本当か Tomoyo.
Yeah, it's not that bad, having the student council president for a girlfriend.
そうか。よかった。ずっと不安だったんだ。本当に終わるって思ってたんだ。よかった。
Tomoyo puts her forehead against my chest, and I softly caress her hair. Something I couldn't accept had turned into something acceptable. I wonder if it's because of this family she often talks about. I wonder if Tomoyo is something like family to me. The entire time we had been separated. However, we both bore the exact same feelings. Both of us had been born to cold households with no warmth at all. She truly was a long-lost relative. Well, I guess that is what people call soulmates. So yeah, it seems we didn't fuck up. I mean, at least, as of now. Maybe for later. But hey, yay! Well done. I hear the sound of the curtains being opened, and radiant light pierces my eyes.
Tomoya, 朝だぞ。
Huh? I squint with half-open eyes, and confirm that there is a female student standing in my room. I see. So this means I also chose to keep on waking up like this too. To be honest, it's pretty tough. Tomoyo.
Nanda.
Let's break up. Although our time was short, it was fun. I once again surrender to my drowsiness and turn over in my bed, and I once again repeat the same lines I already said.
それは冗談か?冗談なんだな?早く冗談だと言え!
Are you fucking kidding me? I swear to God we already did that. I quickly rise up from my bed. Tomoyo is sitting on the corner of the bed, looking down at the floor. Tomoyo, you really are a cute girl, aren't you? Why, you at least take your boyfriend's words at face value. Yeah, I guess that is true. Well, I'd at least want you to take the compliments I give you as a man seriously. In that case... Jesus. Taking this way too serious, lady. Taking this way too serious. Or I'm overly unsensitive. Who knew? Who knows? Yeah, well, then accept that it is a joke. I will be alone forever. without saying anything, I tightly hug her from behind. But she is taking this too seriously. Come on. I never thought I'd ever come to like a person this much.
おはよう。
We pass through the morning school gates as she busily exchanges greetings with people. Yeah, a bit to be fair. Well, to be fair, if you're just two delinquents who never had, like, proper education, you could be her bodyguards. And I'm not shitting on bodyguards here, I'm just saying. Well, just suffer through it. What's wrong? Yeah, you've gone crazy, all right. He turns around and then dashes away. Tomoyo looks back. Looks like he's going back home to sleep.
面白い。それは私への挑戦だな。よし、受けてやろう。
Tomoyo also goes dashing away. So Nohara is being dragged along.
ビデオの録画忘れただけっすよ。
嘘つけ。テレビさえないだろう。あの。
Whoops. It looks quite pitiful. And then lunch break.
来るかね、Tomoyo ちゃん。いや、生徒会長。
Don't you think she'll come as long as we tell her not to?
生徒会長と一緒にお食事かよ。
Do you think it will be different?
きっと高速にうるさくなるからな。三角食べを強要されるかもしれない。
Sankakutabe, okay. Sankakutabe is a proper way of eating lunch involving separating one's food into three portions: bread, a side dish, and soup, in that order. Ah, okay. Cool. Good to know. What are you? A grade schooler?
Higeru!
どうした?大きな声を出して。
Too late, my friend, too late. It was just one step too late.
てめえな。
Taking the offensive, Sunohara presses on Tomoyo.
野菜だけ先に食べてやるぞ、こら。
何を言ってるんだ、こいつは。
He's just an idiot.
うん、そうだったな。
納得するなよ。トモヨ、てめえ、あんまり口うるさくしてるとな。
何か知らないが、言いがかりは後にしてくれ。忙しいんだ。
Huh? With what?
生徒会の招集がかかっている。行かなくてはならない。
Is that so?
これだけを置きに来た。二人で食べてくれ。
She places something wrapped in a large handkerchief on the table.
二人って、僕の?
ああ、お前にも一応、世話になったからな。
Well, at least you're a fair person.
じゃあ、また後でな。
She deftly turns around and leaves gallantly.
なるほど。こうなってくると生徒会に入ったって感じだな。なんかすでに貫禄あるし。
I think her dignity has always been there, though.
そりゃ言えてる。
So, how about you sit down?
ああ、そうだった。もう飯を買いに行く必要もなくなったんだったな。あいつもいいとこあるじゃん。
Sunohara pulls out his chair and takes out the lunch box from the handkerchief.
2つあるってことは、どっちがお前ので、どっちが僕のかわからないよな。
Oh, will this be a hilarious haha on Sunohara's lunch box is like written baka in rice or something like that. We'll see. What came out from the handkerchief was one elliptical, lovely lunch box made of plastic and one square lunch box made of aluminum. Oh well, okay, that's also a way of telling.Well, at least they made the joke more subtle. But still, don't you think it's a little weird that she'd give you a lunchbox? No, what I mean is, don't you think she's trying to use this as a coup de grace? Coup de grace, my bad. To Tomoyo, your existence is nothing but a nuance. To Tomoyo, your existence is nothing but an... Oh, I'm reading bullshit because I don't know how to pronounce the word. Nuisance. Nuisance. Something that sounds French. I mean, if only you didn't exist, it would be just her and me during lunch break. Poison? A bomb. Once you open it up, you'll be blown to smitheriness. You're right. Then I bet it's poison. A poison that will make you want to strip naked and fly out of the window while screaming, Yeehaw!
マジかよ! そんな死に方は嫌だ! せめて、服着たままで死にたい!
Then I'll make sure that when you're on the verge of jumping, you're somehow still wearing your underwear.
Thank you! さすが親友だな!
Again, Spanish for thank you. Really?
で、そんな暇あるなら止めろよ!
Stopping or not stopping you is a whole different story.
なんでだよ。ほら、思い出せよ。僕結構いいやつだっただろ。
Yeah, you're right. I know. How about this then? If at that time, even a single person in the class says, hey, actually was... No, not hey. He actually was a surprisingly good person, don't you think? I'll come and stop you. Still, better than the scenario before. No, they'd simply be jumping the gun a bit, so it's totally possible.
そこまで恨まれてねえよ、僕は。ほら、トモヨって恥ずかしがりだからさ、今日みたいに自分がその場にいないときはちゃんと優しくしてくれるんだよ。この弁当なんかほら、今まで意地悪してごめんねって感じじゃん。No,
I'm still waiting for this for the writing or the picture she made in the bento box. I'll tell you this as her boyfriend. 98% of that is just your delusion. Sonohara opens the aluminum box. It's a lunchbox, so I think it will be cold to begin with, though. I also open up mine. My lunchbox has the same kind of colorful and lovely contents as yesterday. And Sonohara's? Was a seaweed lunch. So, does it feel like you're sorry for being nasty until now? That sounds about right. Well, fair enough. I mean, better than nothing. Well, it's true, she might have made it offhandedly, but I'm sure it will. It's still delicious. As mentioned, just take what you can get, my friend. Just take what you can get. She's probably still busy. I do think she'll come though, albeit a bit late. In front of my eyes are the empty lunchboxes, wrapped in the handkerchief. She might be late, but she'll come. I have no doubt about that. Yeah. Oh, you probably have to wait a while, I guess. My classmates all start to go home. It looks like once you become a third year, you don't even entertain the idea of hanging around the classroom to kill time afterward. So, judging from what happened as of now, the conflict isn't actually getting her into the student council, the conflict is that it's probably going to go on Tomoya's nerves or something like that. But that is again just me speculating. Yeah. The speakers used for school broadcasting start making a noise. Someone must be starting a broadcast. Then the chime signaling the start of a broadcast rings. Also a way of telling him that. Sonohara and I both fall out of our chairs at the same time. The last thing we hear is a chastising voice as the broadcast is cut. Well, you should know that from experience by now. Would she really be alright doing something like that? But still, does it really take up that much time, being student council president? In the end, the two of us go home alone together. Several people holding large boxes of cardboard boxes. I guess just cardboard boxes. But I'm not sure. Huh? Oh, already? Really? Oh, yeah. The homeroom teacher did say something about that. But well, we third years don't have to do anything, so it doesn't matter for us. Why? But I mean, Mommy, I can't read this. Man, I really need to. You know what? Let's stop the episode here. I'm misreading shit all the time, and I can't pronounce shit, although I don't even know that word. But until next episode, I will have looked it up in Google Translator. But okay, this is getting interesting now. So it's not like I had expected it to be, as mentioned. It wasn't like about the tough journey to get her into the student council. It's apparently about the them having a tough time being a couple, as she is the student council president. So we'll see how that develops. I have to say, so far, I like how the story played out. It's interesting. So, I like it. What can I say? Still, I have my minor complaints, but you know, I do them all the time, so that I don't have to repeat them now. But the story overall, I actually find interesting. And I'm a fair man. I'm a fair man. There are nitpicks I'm having, but overall I think the route is interesting. So, thank everybody for watching. Come back for the next episode. And I'll see you then. Bye-bye.